Hello friends, welcome to Srivali's kitchen. Now I'm going to show you another recipe using wood apple. Here you can see this is what we call the wood apple or Velakaya in Telugu. I just broke it open. Just have to bash it with a pestle like this. Break it open. You can see the inside, this fleshy part. This is a little raw. So I'm going to use this to make a raita. So we're going to prepare wood apple raita today. All we need is a handful of ingredients. So we have the wood apple pulp, curd, ginger and green chilies, which have crushed, you know. It doesn't have to be fine, you just roughly crush it. Then some coriander leaves and of course salt, turmeric and ingredients for tempering. What we are going to do first is we are going to scoop out this pulp into a dish, add some water to it and let it boil for about 5 minutes. Not much time because this is raw. It is going to be a bitter along, it's going to be a little bitter. It's going to have a very different taste to it. It's going to be tangy also, so it's going to be a little sour, a little tangy, a little bitter. We're just going to boil it in some water for about 5 minutes and you know, just drain that water so that any of the bitterness of this pulp will get drained along with the water. We're going to let it cool, add some yogurt, salt, turmeric and give it a tempering. Of course, the crushed paste of ginger and green chilies. Simple recipe, right? So now I'm going to take a dish and scoop the pulp into it. So yes, here you just take a spoon and scoop it. You don't have to wash the insides. You just wash the wood apple as it is. Wipe it with a cloth and then you can bash it. Just be careful, don't hurt your fingers. And okay, make sure kids are not around. This bit you can see here, the remaining, it's going to stay to the, stick to the walls of the shell. So we are going to leave it as it is because this has too much fiber in it. And no matter how much you boil, it is still going to be bitter and raw. So we will not use that. We're just going to use the pulp that we can easily scoop out. And these seeds you see here are very much edible and tasty to eat. So you don't have to remove any of these seeds. Here, just pour in some water. You don't need much water either. Dunk this in and put it on the stove. Cover it with a lid so that it will cook faster. And once it kind of looks cooked or boiled, we're just going to drain that water, let it cool, then finish it off. A little more water is also fine. Simple. Now I'm just going to cover this with the lid and cook it for 5 minutes. So here we have the wood apple pulp nicely cooked and the excess water drained. It took me exactly 4 minutes to get this cooked with the lid on and I drained the excess water almost immediately so that it cools down faster. Then just with the spoon you just kind of mash it a little like this. Not much, just a little. This, something of this texture will do. So to this we are going to add the roughly crushed paste of green chilies and ginger. Then we are going to add some salt and some turmeric powder. I'm going to add some turmeric powder. And then we're going to add some salt to it. Mix it up a little again. You don't have to keep mixing it, just roughly give it a small mix. That will be enough. Now to this I'm going to add the curd yogurt. If you want, you can take the yogurt into a dish, beat it until it is smooth and fluffy, and then add, or you can add it directly. Add it gradually, because some of you might like it thick, some of you might like it a little runny. So it's basically a personal choice as to how the consistency of the raita. I like it something in between, not too thick, not too runny. Going to mix this up. Okay, this is how I like it. And then we have the oil for tempering ready. Here I have oil which is already hot. I'm going to add some mustard seeds, cumin seeds or jeera, fenugreek, methi seeds, dry red chilies, not much of dry red chilies, maybe 3. Dry red chilies, and then I'm going to add some asafoetida or hing. I'm going to let the mustard seeds pop and splatter. Then I'm going to turn off the heat. Add the tempering to the wood apple raita mix. Right here we have the mustard seeds popping. You can see that the fenugreek, methi seeds or the fenugreek seeds have changed their color. So we can turn off the heat. Now at this stage, you can either add the raw coriander leaves directly to the raita, or you can just stir it. Just toss it around a little. And add this mixture to this. That's mix it up nicely. Take some raita, add it back to the tempering pan, scoop out all the flavors. This is what gives you the maximum flavor. Give it a good mix. Take it into a serving bowl, and so you can serve this with rice, roti. You can try it with dosa also. You can serve it with parantha. Whatever you like. So now I'm going to take this into a serving bowl. So here we have wood apple raita ready to serve with rice, roti, paratha, whatever you like. You can prepare this for both lunch and dinner, and it's going to stay good for one day. So it's better not to stir it for the next day, but since it has curd in it, it will turn sour. Thank you for watching, and if you like my videos, do subscribe to my YouTube channel called The Sriva Leaf Kitchen. All you have to do is press the red button below the video which says subscribe, and you'll be subscribed to my channel. Have a nice day.